Rhode Island's Lamar Odom has a lot to smile about. He might just be the cream of the freshman crop, and his all-around ability to dribble, to pass, and to score have left many comparing him to former college great Magic Johnson. And tonight, you just might see why. Continue Championship Week presented by 7-Up. Tonight, action in the Atlantic 10 Conference. It's quarterfinal action. From Philadelphia, the Explorers of LaSalle take on the Rhode Island Rams. And here's what's gone on in the A-10s. Temple with a win. Xavier eliminated UMass. GW held off Dayton. They had a big lead and wound up surviving by about 10 or 12. And now tonight, LaSalle and Rhode Island. Hi again, everybody. Dave Sims along with Jay Billis. Good to have you with us. And this LaSalle club, Jay, is a pretty dangerous ball club. Third leading scoring team in the A-10, and they came out blazing last night.
Well, there's no question they can put points on the board. LaSalle has four guys that can put up 20 or more points on you. And they started off on fire last night against St. Joseph. Shot 59% in the first half, getting off to a 16-4 initial lead. Donnie Carr was brilliant. He had 21 points. Victor Thomas had 16 points, 12 rebounds. He was magnificent.
Marquee guy tonight. No question about it. Lamar Odom, they call him the package. Yep, he can do just about anything there needs to be done on a basketball court.
Well, surprise, surprise, Lamar Odom made the all-rookie team. In fact, he was the A-10's rookie of the year and first team All-Atlantic 10. An exceptional passer and ball handler. He's learning to assert himself and take over games. He is capable of a triple-double.
Take a look at our Western Union starting lineups. Donnie Carr, Blanks, Butler, Thomas, and Kazel Wesson is the seventh leading rebounder in the United States. And for Rhode Island, Tavares Bell, Preston Murphy, Odom, Reynolds Dean, and Luther Clay back from a calf injury. Reynolds Dean, solid, never misses a game, dependable, and he can do some scoring too underneath and a good rebounder. And we are seconds away from the opening tip.
Both teams expecting to have an up and down game with a lot of points put on the board, especially Speedy Morris.
Speedy Morris, believe it or not, in his final year of his contract, some talk from the new AD, Tom Brennan, has said, we'll wait till the end of the season, but nothing short of sacrilege here in Philadelphia, thinking about getting rid of Speedy Morris. And Jim Herrick, 19th season as head coach, having a great year, 17-12 with the Rams. They went 10-6. A-10 regular season, of course, won the 95 national championship at UCLA. Brian Kersey, Mark DiStiola, and Kent Clark are officials. Brian Kersey will get us underway with the opening tip. Odom jumping with Victor Thomas, and the LaSalle Explorers on the offensive first. Boy, they shot so well last night, 16-4, 13-3 rather, to start the game last night. First 4 minutes is basically over right there against St. Joseph's.
Rhode Island starting off in man-to-man, a lot of switching on those screens.
Kazel Wesson goes down to the low blocks to score. Double-double man.
Luther Clay just playing behind Kazel Wesson, just got back down and help came a little bit too late.
Boris Bell, here's Odom. Turns and line drives it off the glass. Lamar Odom.
LaSalle starting off in man-to-man as well, but they are not getting out in passing lanes or defending out to the three-point line. They're sloughing back. They're just going to guard Preston Murphy out to the line.
Reynolds Dean guarding Thomas. Blanks guarded by Murphy.
Their play is pushing Wesson out a little further. Tougher to make that move.
Murph came down, bothered him, almost took it away. Nice cut to the hole and a pass, but a miss by Thomas.
How about Odom getting to pull down the rebound, then he can take it down himself. What a passer he is.
Tavares Bell, that won't go. Reynolds Dean the rebound. Antonio goes up. The roll won't fall for him. And it will stay right here. Rhode Island ball. Rhode Island leading in this series. Won the last six. Odom, big numbers, last time out. Back in January 21st.
That was a game where LaSalle did not shoot the ball well at all. Only turned it over five times. Good defense by Thomas.
Sure was. Thomas got a piece of that one. And a turnover. Bell walked with it as he picked off the pass from Blanks.
Bell drawing yet another difficult assignment defensively, having to go against Donnie Carr, one of the leading scorers in the Atlantic 10, a guy who knows how to get shots off, work off of screens. But Bell has had tough defensive assignments all season long.
LaSalle, in this round, after winning its first ever Atlantic 10 tournament game, after losing for 3 years.
Luther Clay going over the top of Kazel Wesson, and it doesn't seem to matter what kind of position you get on Kazel Wesson. He winds up with inside position. He never surrenders to a blockout.
Outstanding. Top rebounder in the Atlantic 10, Donnie Carr. Nice pass. Thomas inside, draws the foul. They get Odom. First foul on Lamar.
Donnie Carr with the ability to put the ball on the floor, break the defense down, the nice little spin getting to the basket, and a good basket cut by Victor Thomas. Lamar Odom having to come over from the weak side, as did Luther Clay.
Victor Thomas out of St. John Newman High School here in Philadelphia.
Really matured into a fine player, averaged about 11 points a game last year, and what was a bit of a surprise, showed flashes of great talent, and this year has really become or blossomed into a terrific scorer.
Thomas on the second. Knocks it down. And LaSalle with a 3-2 lead. Dump it down to Clay with the turnaround. It's good. Nice soft touch by Luther Clay, a junior out of Overland, Ohio.
Rasual Butler was guarding Lamar Odom. He did not drop down to double team. He will not leave Odom. They don't want to let him get started.
Rasual Butler, long range, hits a three, off to a good start. Rasual Butler, a Roman Catholic here in Philadelphia.
He's the Philly High School Player of the Year last year, not eligible to play till after the first semester, started against Niagara. And they were happy to get him at LaSalle. He's a big-time recruit.
Preston Murphy, rebounded by Kazel Wesson. On open floor for the Explorers, Donnie Carr, quick trigger, short rebound Thomas. And Thomas scores, so things flowing nicely for the Explorers. They lead it 8-4.
Similar start for LaSalle, knocking down some shots. Rasual Butler hitting that three. That was a big shot for them.
Reynolds Dean under pressure. That one won't go. Wesson another rebound. He's got four.
Luther Clay's got to bump Kazel Wesson. He's just running right down into the low block. He's got to meet him at the free throw line, get some work done early.
Thomas, a stroke from outside. My goodness, how about LaSalle? 11-4, 8-0 run for the Explorers.
When Luther Clay lets Kazel Wesson get that position down low, he can get fed into the post and then relocate if he doesn't have a shot to an open shooter.
Talk about a team feeling good about itself. A little confusion right now on the floor. Rhode Island trying to get this offense going. Reynolds Dean had it knocked away momentarily by Blanks. Odom with 12 on the shot clock.
Watch this guy's handle. Remember, he's 6'10 when he's doing all these things.
Draws the foul on Butler.
Lamar Odom is an incredibly skilled left-handed basketball player. At 6'10, he's got the ability to go by you with quickness and ball handling ability. He can also pull up for the deep jump shot. One thing that he has got to work on is posting up. He does not get to the free throw line as often as he should. Gets there mostly off the dribble instead of posting up smaller guys.
Lamar 68% at the line this year.
He has put up, Dave, some remarkable numbers in this conference for a guy who's 19 years old. He's fifth in scoring, second in rebounding, second in field goal percentage, 10th in assists.
Winner of this game will advance to take on George Washington. 11-5 LaSalle really going.
This will be an up and down game, and the winner will have an up and down game against GW.
Kazel Wesson, tell you what, killing Luther Clay down low, and Luther not getting any help either.
It's like guarding a small building.
And Odom on the attack. And they get Victor Thomas on the foul, his first. Take a look at Kazel Wesson.
He does such good work to get the low post position, and Luther Clay, as the ball gets reversed, little penetration, and Luther Clay not ready to knock that ball away. Kazel Wesson got down, made the good catch, and the little drop step to the basket.
One thing about Kazel Wesson, he is very efficient inside. Not a lot of wasted motion or wasted movement.
Senior out of Portland, Oregon. 6'7", 253, and uses every bit of it. Good trip to the line for Odom. 13-7, LaSalle leading Rhode Island. We take a timeout with them back after this.
Today, people who didn't send the money, Western Union, and the heartbreak it caused. So what happened?
My Aunt Leona called. She was throwing a party and she sprung a leak.
She did?
Well, her tub did. And I told Mercury here to send money.
I did.
But not Western Union.
Her aunt sprung a leak and you didn't use Western Union?
No, and it took forever.
And what does Aunt Leona have to say?
Hey, it's your money. Use Western Union, the fastest way to send money worldwide.
The Michelin X1. Thanks to Michelin technology, it gives you long mileage and better wet braking than any rain tire. And that should make everyone on a wet road happy.
Make money? Read Forbes.
Call now and get a risk-free issue of Forbes filled with ways to make money and get ahead in business. If you like it, we'll send you 13 more issues for just $19.97, and you'll get the Forbes Investment Guide free. Call now for Forbes.
LaSalle on top of Rhode Island. 4 minutes and change into the first half here in Philadelphia, A-10 quarterfinal action. Don't forget, coming up on Sunday, the NCAA Selection Show, the Women's Selection Show presented by State Farm, 5:15 Eastern Time. Then the Men's Tournament Selection Show at 6:30 Eastern. Chris Fowler hosting that one. Analysis by Dick Vitale, Digger Phelps, and Jay Billis. Top 64 teams and their seeds in the upcoming NCAA Basketball Tournament. You'll get to know where everybody's going. Great start for LaSalle. 5-for-8 from the field, 63%. Rhode Island struggling at 2-for-7 from the field.
Rhode Island sticking with man-to-man, switching a lot of the screens.
And Wesson lost the handle out of bounds.
Julian Blanks needed to take one more dribble down to that baseline to make that pass. He made the pass right to the stanchion, and that does not do any good. It doesn't lead Kazel Wesson into his move. Wesson was trying to hold off the defender. If he would have taken a dribble to the baseline, he could have fed him for an easy basket.
Odom, hook shot, good. Turn around. Odom with 7 points.
There is not a thing that Lamar Odom cannot do on a college basketball court. I say college because I know he is considering jumping to the NBA. And if he needs the money, that's one thing, but his game is just not quite ready yet.
There's Odom, a little bit too far on the lead. Butler with no call. Back comes LaSalle. Donnie Carr, quick trigger, won't go. Rebound, nice job by Luther Clay. Rhode trying to get something going on the offensive end. Murphy with the pull-up. Murph misses that one.
Well, that would have been nice to look back to Odom, who was the trailer on that play, setting up for perhaps a better look. Preston Murphy had to shoot that ball over the outstretched arms of Kazel Wesson.
Donnie Carr got it. 4-3. Donnie Carr with the 3-point shot. He's 35% from long range. And LaSalle leads 16-9.
Much better rhythm there, wasn't it? A little flare move.
Yep.
He got his feet set and put it up nicely.
Line drive down and out for Lamar Odom.
One thing that LaSalle has got to do is clean up the defensive board. That means a lot more than just Kazel Wesson. Everybody's got to go to the glass.
Thomas up top. Sewell Butler. Butler looks like just a slightly taller version of Thomas.
Yeah, a couple high school phenoms.
Yeah. Kazel Wesson, that's a power move. Count it.
It takes a lot to control a big body like Kazel Wesson, but that was excellent body control. Luther Clay standing straight up. And the nice little spin move as Preston Murphy came by. Wesson took the ball back and was able to avoid the block, yet get the contact and finish the play.
Second foul on Luther Clay. 13 rebounds. 18-9, LaSalle doubling up on Rhode Island. Rhode Island lost to Fordham in its final game of the season, 74-70. Odom out with the flu, Clay out with the leg injury. Reynolds Dean, nice rebound there.
You can see Wesson not going out to guard Clay on the perimeter.
Tavares Bell, that had no chance. Odom up strong, that won't go. They battle for it, it'll stay right here.
I think Bell threw that off the backboard to see if Luther Clay could get it. He knew he couldn't make the shot. It was more of a pass, and that was not the pass that Jim Herrick likes to see. You see Rhode Island, the better rebounding team, plus six per game on the season. And LaSalle has had some rebounding difficulties.
Brody's got the last four rebounds. Odom, very smooth, just takes it right where he wants it and scores. So Lamar, he's got 9 points, 9 of the 11 for Rhode Island.
He just glides to the basket, doesn't he?
Blanks on a curl. It's been working. They go to Kizell Wesson. Blanks over the top, a little short. Thomas, can he save it? Call a timeout.
No, I think he stepped on the line.
Oh, okay. He tried to call a timeout. And it will be Rhode Island ball. Big Ed Brown coming into the game. And Tip Vincent is in the game.
Lamar Odom, when he puts the ball on the floor, boy, just gets to the basket so easily and so effortlessly. One of those players that you can't really tell how hard he's working because it seems so easy for him. But he is a hard worker and has been working hard to improve his game, trying to assert himself more.
Tip Vincent to Bell. Odom guarded by Butler. Luther Clay wheels. Jump hook won't go. Thomas rebounds.
See, Odom made that pass and just stood there. He needs to move once he lets that pass in there. Might get a relocation pass. His man will at least have to pay attention to him, and it'll be an easy move, an easier move for Luther Clay.
Donnie Carr threw it right to Odom. He thought he had a cutter. He didn't. Odom to the glass. Oh, look at that extension, and he missed it, though. And here comes LaSalle back the other way. Sewell Butler, why not? Short rebound to Tip Vincent. Back comes Rhode. Man ahead of the pack is Odom, and he's got it.
Good look ahead by Tip Vincent.
It's going to be interesting to battle down low, Jay, with Big Ed Brown in the game now against Kizell Wesson. Ed Brown at 290 right now, down from 341 at the start of the season. Donnie Carr sets up Thomas, stepped inside, he beat Luther Clay, third on Luther. It's a solid development for LaSalle to get three fouls on Luther Clay with 11:41 to go in the first half. We'll take a timeout, and Odom smooth to the hoop, but Brody trailing by five.
Morning, Craig.
Morning.
How do you plan on funding your retirement? Conseco's annuities and mutual funds can help. Conseco, step up.
Peter from the Plank Road Brewery. We wanted to thank the Bunchiest for drinking our beers. The glorious, never watered down taste of nectar we call Ice House.
Yeah, we spend 80 hours a week here. But for us, it's a labor of love. It's a gift. It's a craft. It's an art.
Like macrame.
So, anyways, thanks for drinking our beers. Enjoy. What can we say? Out here, our world is beer.
At a standstill, it might be compared to other sport bikes. At top end, it might be compared to other sport bikes. But at each and every mile per hour in between, comparisons become insignificant specks in the mirrors. The TL1000R, the only one of its kind on the track, from Suzuki.
Well, LaSalle by five here in A-10 quarterfinal action. 11:41 to go, first half, and get your engines revved up, everybody. Vroom, vroom. You got the Busch Grand National, Samstown. 300 coming your way, 4 p.m. Eastern time on Saturday. Stars of the NASCAR Busch Series head to Las Vegas. Tackle that 1.5-mile Las Vegas National Motor Speedway. Jimmy Spencer, the defending champion. However, Jeff Gordon hopes to put his name in the record books as he makes his first Busch Series start in the number 24 Pepsi Chevrolet with a brand new race team owned by a wife, Brooke, and Winston Cup crew chief, Ray Evernham.
And Speedy Morris, happy this year to be playing in the new Tom Gola Arena. They have their own on-campus facility now that's been refurbished, a place where now they can get in, practice every day, shoot, play their games there, and it's been a nice home court advantage. Only lost to GW this year at home.
Rasual Butler missed. Ed Brown had it. Kazel Wesson runs it down. I'm having breakfast this morning. I see this familiar figure come in. I said, geez, I can't place it at dawn. I slapped myself in the head. Hey, stupid, that was Tom Gola. I only grew up here in Philly. I'm looking at this guy and say, geez, I know it is.
Looks great. Tom Gola from the 1954 national champion, LaSalle Explorers, and Lamar Odom, so important to this team. 4 of 8, the rest of the team have missed 8 shots on ball by themselves. And when Odom plays well, this team goes well.
Rhode on the run after the turnover. Odom trying to think ahead. Boy, that was a nice play as he flipped it off of Butler's legs.
He's got a great presence out on the basketball floor. Lamar Odom, great hands, the ability to catch. And he let that one go, but still had the presence to save it off of somebody's leg and knock it out of bounds, keep possession.
Back to live action. Tavares Bell on the miss. Back comes LaSalle, up by 5.
And Lamar Odom, for all he has been through, relatively unaffected by it all.
Donnie Carr. And Bell's going to come back for Rhode.
Preston Murphy early on in this season sprained a couple ankles. Odom had to play point guard at 6.
Isn't that amazing? As Reynolds-Dean scores in, yeah, that game against Providence early on in the season. Providence did a good job running 2 people at Lamar and make sure he gives the ball up. They wound up blowing Rhode Island out.
Well, that's the wrong team to have to go against your first starting assignment with Corey Wright and John Linehan. A couple Shante Rogers is out there.
Oh, God. Super quick. Ed Brown is easiest rebound. Mr. Outlet, Jeez. Look at that. Oh, baby. Jim Herrick said he outlets the ball better than anyone he's ever had. That's right out of the Wes Unseld school.
That was like a strongman contest. How far and how hard can you throw the ball?
Man, oh, man. I tell you what, folks. Next time you're on a basketball court, stand at one end of the 94 feet and try to throw it that far. See how far you can throw it. He made this look awfully easy.
Look at that. It's like he threw a bullet down there. That's an overhead pass. Yeah, you said earlier that he dropped down from 341 to 290. It'll be a while until he sees 290 again. But I'll tell you what, for a guy his size, Ed Brown, very light on his feet. He can move. He jumps very well.
He had 22 points the other day against Fordham.
Right, in a game when Lamar Odom did not play and Luther Clay had only 2 points because of a strained left calf. And he has been the Amityville horror for a lot of teams with as well as he has played and his size. He can change the game when he gets in there.
Biggest player ever at Rhode Island. Transfer from St. John's.
I think Kazel Wesson's asking him that right now. Aren't you the biggest player ever at Rhode Island? You seem like you're the biggest player ever.
Tell you what.
You're certainly bigger than the last guy that was guarding me.
That is a notable difference. I started on the box and I ended up in Herrick's lap. Get it into Butler. Sal's lead down to 1 as Donnie Carr operates. And we'll walk the floor there. Preston Murphy stood his ground quite well.
You know, Preston Murphy has always been a very good defender here, having to take on Donnie Carr down in the low post, and Carr just lowered that shoulder, and Preston Murphy maybe put a little bit extra into it, but did a nice job drawing the charge. The senior has been part of the most successful class in Rhode Island history. Won over 80 games together in 4 years, being Antonio Reynolds' team.
A couple of heartbeats away from the Final 4 last year.
Bet you they hate Arthur Lee.
I won't even mention his name.
Yeah, you're not allowed in the state of Rhode Island.
Here's Reynolds Dean, and he gets the roll. Antonio Reynolds Dean gives Rhode Island the lead, 19-18.
Reynolds Dean has been about as steady a performer as you can ask for, coming out of the Miami class in 1995.
Wesson had to give that one up. Butler outside. Butler front rim.
And Murphy.
Off the tap from Vincent gets the rebound. Nice. Takes it all the way down. Knock it out of bounds. It'll stay Rhode Island ball with 28 on the shot clock.
Good look by Preston Murphy. Nice job defensively by Thomas to come out of nowhere and knock that away.
Good hustle. Dean trying to post up and battling with Thomas.
Thomas, although he's not as strong as Reynolds Dean, doing a nice job using his quickness to try to get around in front.
Murphy checks the clock. He's got 12 left. Puts it up. Won't go. They keep it alive. Tizell Wesson wins that battle. Donnie Carr back the other way. Blanks into the corner. Tizell Wesson. They take it away. Nice shot by Vincent.
Well, that size of Ed Brown just stops Kazel Wesson, allows the other defenders to come over and give help.
And Vincent did everything but complete the play. Last man back is Ed Brown. Here's LaSalle on the break. And he scores. He beat Brown.
And that's a nice job by Blanks to square his shoulders to the basket. Had a good opportunity for a three-point play there.
And a six-minute drought for the Explorers.
Sal has been a very good team at home, not as good of a team on the road. The only road win the A-10 they had was at Dayton.
Torrey Jefferson in the game and got a foul against Rhode Island. They get Ed Brown for the foul, his first. Check that, Torrey Jefferson, his first. Blanks on the run for LaSalle. Explorers get the lead right back here at the 7:30 mark in Philadelphia.
Here's a question. Want to save on electricity? If you need extra cash, here's a question. Want to save on electricity? Well, the simple answer is Exelon Energy. Exelon. There's still time for you to save money for a full year with our guaranteed low price. So call right now to sign up. It's easy, easy. It's fast, fast. And if you don't call, you're leaving money on the table. With Exelon, you get dependable customer service day or night, plus your choice of billing options. And we make it so simple to save. Just push a button and call toll-free. Or click a button and go to exeloncorp.com. Just push a button or click a button, but whatever you do, do it now. Call. Because the sooner you sign up, the faster you'll save with Exelon Energy.
To save on electricity in Pennsylvania, call Exelon right now at 1-877-475-9361. That's 1-877-475-9361.
I was passionate about my artwork, but...
Once we finish a show, we do it all over again for the overseas markets.
No hands for kids.
Buenas noches, amigos. Me llamo Kenny Mayne.
Same highlights, same anchors, different dialects.
Dos vidania. Menu za vut, Boris Patrick.
Vut, Kenny Mainsky.
To touch people all over the world, that's special.
Dave Feldman in the Deuce Studio, a Conference USA quarterfinals, St. Louis and Louisville, and Kevin Smiley. Watch this. It's not a good pass. Oh, that's a mistake. Dave Ferguson the other way in the hoop. And right now, it's 19-18, Louisville over the Billikens. And in the ACC, the first round, the number one team in the nation is the Duke Blue Devils, and they're up big 13-5. Let's go back to Dave and Jay.
Back here in Philadelphia. Good look at Logan Circle, the fountains here in downtown Philadelphia as we look at City Hall and the tower at the end there with William Penn, the statue of Billy Penn on top. 20-19, LaSalle. Winner advances to the semifinals tomorrow night against George Washington, and a miscue right there from Blanks and Wesson.
Like trying to catch a bullet.
9 turnovers for the Explorers. And they average just under 15 per game.
Odom trying to take Rasual Butler inside right now.
Ed Brown wheels, fires, and got the roll. Ed Brown on the board, 21-20 Rhode Island.
How about the big guy with the nice touch, little lean in and then fadeaway jumper?
The LaSalle's productivity to this point. 44% from the field.
And a big difference from their game last night. Not so much that they're not hitting the same shots, but they're turning the ball over much more.
Wesson, boy, I tell you what, under duress now with Ed Brown in it. Yeah, changed the complexion.
Yeah, you might as well chalk that up as a turnover. Because that was not a good shot taken by Kazel Wesson.
He was getting in move early on, and he got it all night last night against St. Joseph's. Odom on the left side with the lefty, and he scores. Made it look easy again. 23-20. Lamar's got 13.
Well, just great recognition by Lamar Odom. He had Julian Blank switched off on him, and he took Blanks down low.
Lance Blanks, of course, but played for the University of Texas.
That's right, for Tom Pender.
Tom Pender, sure. Butler with the triple.
Butler shooting Blanks out.
Night at 23. Is there a baseball player, Larvell Blanks, too? The Cubs or the Tigers. Tip in is good. And Odom with yet another basket. He's got 15. Heck of a start here.
And whoever's got him, when it's Thomas, it's difficult for Thomas to block him out. It's also difficult for Rasual Butler. And Rasual Butler, not a terrific rebound. Needs to concentrate a little more on that skill.
Big trigger there by Thomas. I'll tell you what, Ed Brown's presence has made a heck of a difference in this game. Defensive end for Rhode Island. Takes an option away from LaSalle. Reynolds Dean down deep. Ed Brown scores his second bucket. 27-23. The people's choice of Rhode Island. Ed Brown.
And a terrific pass by Antonio Reynolds Dean. Did a nice job of reading the defense. But again, when Odom throws that ball inside, he's got to move. Can't just stand.
Thomas, corner. Oh, good up there. Butler, pull up. Intermediate jump shot. Say hallelujah, you basketball purists. He stepped into it nicely. 8 points for Butler.
Only having played a half season, he's still trying to get his game together, but all the pieces are there for Rasual Butler to be a terrific basketball player.
Murphy took it deep and got a foul on Wesson.
Always want to keep your feet against a jump shooter. Little up fake. Lamar Odom flies right by in one dribble. And Rasual Butler pulls up for the short intermediate range jump shot. And that's a difficult shot about 8 to 10 feet out along the baseline.
Saw Virginia Tech's Eddie Lucas shoot that ball well, that same type of shot. In our first game at noon earlier this afternoon on ESPN.
And that's something that Eddie Lucas of Virginia Tech has worked very hard at. Taking 250, 300 shots a day. He's one of those guys that gets to practice early, gets to games early, and works on his shooting.
Garrett Bragg, you saw him come into the game. Garrett Bragg, number 52 for LaSalle for Kazel Wesson. Bragg fouled out in a nanosecond last night. Came in at 1 point second half, had 2 fouls, and was gone in a matter of about a couple of minutes.
He's not afraid to throw that body around. He's going to give Ed Brown a taste of his own medicine. Big body against big body.
Bragg listed at 275. Thomas. Ed Brown, what do we got? Foul on Ed. He was in good shape until brought his arms down.
Hey, you bring that arm down, and that's almost always going to be a foul. Ed Brown coming over, doing a nice job trying to establish position to make Thomas go over him. And he can jump there and still maintain good position. You're legal all the way up to the ceiling on the same plane. But once you break that plane and bring your arm down, that's when you're going to get that key vibrating in the whistle.
Thomas, 63% productivity at the line this year. LaSalle trailing by three. Final 4:21, first half.
Thomas has been terrific in conference games, shooting from the three-point line.
Well, look at it, gear Odom had. Ed Brown's got it. Got bumped, lost it. Odom's there, and count it. With 17 first half points, Rhodey by four.
Just ripping the ball down the left hand side. The missed shot, Ed Brown got a couple, gives a little no look leave off, and Lamar Odom almost didn't see it. He just picked it up off the floor.
It's like a pass, isn't it?
He's got a little spice to his game, doesn't he? Well, he can sit down pretty soon, then have to play the rest of the game. I've got my number.
Odom doesn't complete the three-point play. Good look. A little bit too much on it from Donnie Carr. Tensions were certainly correct.
Well, when LaSalle has run their offense and made a couple of passes, if they don't have anything in the open court, they've been pretty successful, but they've got to take better care of the basketball. Got to value it more. You can't keep turning it over.
Odom up top, gives it up, Vincent. And Brown faces up, drives in. You notice no one took the charge.
And very intelligent.
Rasual Butler was standing there, thought better of it.
6 points.
If I run away, I may take a charge another day.
Tell you what, you take a charge, we'll put a tombstone up with your name on it.
Great job by Preston Murphy defensively.
Yeah, there's no plaque coming on. There's no plaque coming. There's a tombstone coming. No doubt about that. 3:29 to go.
Need a red cape there.
Big guy rolling to the hole.
As you get closer, your eyes get wider. Your heart beats faster. Your determination grows strong. This is not going to beat you. Oh, it's loud. And it's dirty. And yeah, it's big. But so are your plans. Hey, John boy, you ain't in Kansas anymore. From here on in, every day's gonna be a test. Those who pass deserve a great beer. Sam Adams, it's what's inside.
The Tax Time Blues. Four and five star tax-free bond funds from American Century. Just call. Thank you.
1-800-660-0092.
I was driving across country to my first job. That's when my car starts making this weird noise. I saw a Firestone store with MasterCare Car Service. They found the problem and suggested a way to fix it that saved me money.
We guarantee to fix it right or your money back.
Cellular One, clear across America.
Back here in Philadelphia, A-10 quarterfinal action. Dave Sims and Jay Billis with you. Rhode Island, 33-27 lead over LaSalle. Final 3:29, first half. Hey, coming up on Saturday on the Deuce, we've got a bunch of championship games for you. The Southwestern Athletic Conference Championship at 2 p.m. from the Clark Center. Then the MEAC from Richmond Coliseum at 7. Then the Big Sky Conference Championship, 10:30 Eastern Time from the D Event Center. ESPN.com, part of the Go Network, go.com.
Montana State still alive in that Big Sky Conference, and they have a great shooter in Danny Sprinkle.
Reynolds Dean, no. Rebound, Ed Brown. Ed Brown, 4 for 4. 8 points, 3 rebounds, and 2 assists.
LaSalle went to a little 2-3 zone out of that timeout. And Ed Brown cleared out the bottom three to get that rebound.
Biggest lead enjoyed by Rhode tonight. Wesson back in the game, wheels on Brown. And scores. Good job by Kazo Wesson. Token double team by Lamar Odom, but he got it over Brown.
Yeah, nice little half hook. And sticking with the 2-3 zone.
Odom against Butler, finds Reynolds Dean. Vincent open, set. Three ball for Tip Vincent.
Nice job getting the ball from side to side to the open shooter, and Tip Vincent keeps a little bit of a line drive, but it goes in.
Knocked away by Ed Brown. Murphy, can he save it? He says he stepped on the line. Quick hands by Ed Brown. Mr. Brown has impacted him.
Oh, absolutely. And especially when Luther Clay is in foul trouble, he has come in and given quality minutes. He may not get up and down the court quickly, but once he gets there, he lets his presence be known.
And so, Luther Clay picked up his third foul, left the game at the 11:41 mark. Carr shoots over. Back rim, Murphy rebound.
Murphy was fortunate there. He went behind the screen.
Yeah. Carr good look. No look. Reynolds Dean. Good pass by Preston Murphy. 40-29, Rhode Island. And Speedy wants a 22nd timeout.
Well, you can tell that Preston Murphy is healthy again. Started out as the point guard this season almost by default. Zach Marbury The freshman who, yes, is Stephon Marbury's little brother, was declared ineligible. And so Preston Murphy had to step into that role, but had ankle injuries. And you can see the big impact of Ed Brown.
Ed Brown making a difference. 23-11. They're on a 17-6 run right now. Coming up, 7 at halftime report at halftime. Dave Feldman bringing that to you. ESPN News breakdown in this tournament. How about UConn, a close one. Once again, Tommy Amaker at Seton Hall scares the daylights out of the Huskies. Rhode takes over again.
Get some halftime analysis.
And how about that? Reynolds Dean from Murphy. Murph with his head up. 42-29. LaSalle's on the run here.
Yeah, that was a good look. And Preston Murphy, a very good passer. Really coming into his own now that he's healthy.
Huge breakdown on the defense for the Explorers. Tough shot. Butler won't go. Odom rebounds.
He grabs the board. He can take it himself.
His pass. Reynolds Dean trying to get it into Ed Brown. Reynolds Dean waits. Off the glass. Won't go. Coming up in the final minute of play. First half.
Rhode Island has been efficient offensively. They have been active defensively. And LaSalle has had no opportunities to get easy shots.
Second time, Ed Brown has tipped that entry pass. And this time, Rhode Island's going to take over. The Explorers knocked it out of bounds. Well, Mr. Brown.
Yeah, Kazel Wesson's just got to do a better job there of holding off inside. You can't let anybody get around you to knock that ball away without going over the top. Our buddy Dave Feldman may be able to talk about that a little bit. At halftime, Dave was an assistant coach to Tom Davis at Stanford. Knows a little bit about the game.
ABC College basketball coming up on Saturday. It's Arizona taking on UCLA. Jason Cherry of the Wildcats, the senior in his last home game, leading the Pac-10 and scoring 22 points, leading in assists and steals. Good matchup, UCLA and Arizona. 3:30 Eastern time on ABC Sports.
Well, Jason Terry may not be the best guard ever at Arizona, but I'm not sure that any guard has had more responsibility heaped on his shoulders in one season than Jason Terry has. Terry has carried this year for the Wildcats. He's been brilliant.
Big lead for Rhode Island, 42-29.
It certainly didn't start out that way, did it?
Sure did. Odom with six. Finds Reynolds Dean. Fade away. Got it. Boy, they're getting everything they want now. 44-29. And LaSalle, final 15 seconds.
He is just an exceptional passer. So difficult to double Lamar Odom because he will find the open man. If you cut to the basket, you're going to be open.
Carr, straight on three ball with five left. Reynolds Dean. Murphy going to let it rip. Oh, he got the backboard. A 21-6 run by Lamar Odom and the Rhode Island Rams over the last 5 minutes. An impressive halftime lead, 44-29. ESPN News coming your way after this timeout.
ESPN2's exclusive presentation of Championship Week is presented by 7-Up. Are you an un?
It is uniquely human, the need to connect, to be a part of something larger. Today, it all starts with a .com address.
Hey, Grandpa?
Network Solutions puts more .com addresses into service than every other internet company combined.
Yeah.
Want to get connected to the internet? First, get connected to Network Solutions. Network Solutions, the .com people.
Used to be the harder the ball, the farther it went. Not anymore. This is the new Top Flight XL 2000. It's got titanium in the cover for explosive distance. On an average par 4, that's 10 yards longer from tee to green. Thing is, the XL 2000 has an amazing soft feel. Softness you can feel and hear. Close to the green? How about close to the pin? The all-new Top Flight XL 2000. Explosive distance, amazing soft feel. It's the best XL I've ever played.
Whoa, very nice.
No, I was talking about the pizza.
Who delivered?
Those toppings.
It's everywhere. You mind telling me who delivered? This is a nightmare.
Who delivered?
It's not delivery.
It's DiGiorno, the rising crust pizza that bakes up fresh like pizzeria pizza.
Great. I'll never know.
This halftime report is presented by 7-Up. Now, for the latest in the world of sports, let's join ESPN News.
This is ESPN News.
Hi, everybody. Welcome to your 24-hour source for sports information. This is ESPN News. Alongside Ian Page, I'm Bill Seward, and we'd be remiss if we didn't continue with our coverage in college basketball.
And we'll continue in the Atlantic 10. Coach Dayton and George Washington a little bit earlier tonight. Good A-10 battle. Shaunte Rogers, the Atlantic 10 Player of the Year. Look at the nice fake, and then he knocks down three of his 28 to put GW up by eight. Then later, Rogers starting the fast break. Watch the nice passing to Igor Mischerikov, who will slam it down and also draws the foul. GW by 10, and then more of the little big man. The pretty pass to Mischerikov. He lays it in. He finished up with 22 points as GW won all three meetings with Dayton this year. They now have won four straight opening games in the Atlantic 10 tournament. So Dayton finishes up the season at 11-17. GW will face the Rhode Island LaSalle winner in the semis tomorrow. That Rhode Island LaSalle game, of course, the game you are watching on ESPN2. Elsewhere in the Atlantic 10, Virginia Tech and Temple, Pepe Sanchez, one of the Atlantic 10 tournament record, eight steals for him, and he goes coast to coast for the layup. Talk about playing some good defense. And then how about Mark Karcher? He was 6 of 8 from three-point range. He had 18 points, all coming from behind the arc. And then Rashid Brokenborough puts up the shot, no good. Lamont Barnes, one of his 13 boards, sticks it back up and in for 2 of his 14. It's Temple. Hangs on to get the win. They win it by your final of 64-51. So Temple gets its 20th win of the season. Virginia Tech finishes up their season at 13-15.
UMass and Xavier, and give it to Xavier, a four-point advantage there. So for Xavier, 21 wins on the season, and they move into the next round of the A-10 tournament. South Florida and Cincinnati, first half, and Cincinnati up one, and Pete Michael. Looking to Melvin Levitt. He had 19. Cincinnati up by three. But Michael showing, yeah, he could pass. He can also slam him down. 2 of his 18, and Cincinnati up by 10. Second half, and Michael, the spin move. Said that it was a coming up and then going inside. To play on the Division One level. 28 points for Michael. Over the last 8 years, Cincinnati 18-1 in conference tournament play under Coach Bob Huggins. The Bearcats will meet the winner of the Southern Miss North Carolina Charlotte game. Speaking of that contest, here it is. North Carolina Charlotte and Southern Miss in the first half, and Southern Miss Earl Flowers driving, and then out to Anthony Richards, who had 10 points in the first half. 10-6 Southern Miss still in the first, and Marlon Thomas to Diego Guevara kicks it out to Tremaine Gardner for three. And North Carolina Charlotte rolling in this one, advancing to the semifinals to take on top-seeded Cincinnati, now just one win away from a third consecutive trip to the Conference USA Finals. This win probably locking up a bid to the NCAAs.
Big East action, Miami and Georgetown. Tim James taking it to the hoop, splits the defender, and gets the hoop and the foul to tie this game at 40. And then tied at 44, Kevin Braswell. Look at him hit the leaner over Mario Bland, who played his high school ball at Callaway High School in Mississippi. Then Miami using the good ball movement in the post. James to John Sammons, who finds Mario Bland, who puts it in off the glass. 2 of his 19. And then Miami just continues to pull away. Johnny Helmsley knocks down the big-time three. He had 18 points, and Miami beats Georgetown for the first time ever in the Big East tournament. As Johnny Helmsley, as I mentioned, finished with 18 points. Georgetown finishes up at 15-15. They will hope for an NIT bid. Miami will face either St. John's or Rutgers in Friday's semifinal action. Seton Hall and UConn, and Richard Hamilton, 2 of 8 from behind the three-point line. There's one of them. He had 15 points, and we're all tied at 45. And then the Hall answering back. Chuck Moore left wide open for three. 3 of his 6 points to put the Hall up by three. Khalid El-Amin, his first field goal of the game after going 0 for 7. He only finished with 6 points. Could they hang on? El-Amin to Kevin Freeman. He jams it down. UConn by 3. And they're hoping they can hang on. Now the Hall down. They need a 3. but they shoot the wild two. Gary Saunders with no good. Reggie Garrett, no good. Garrett follows, but that one goes. The Hall down by one. Jim Calhoun says, come on, let's talk about this. Gary Saunders at the free throw line. They need a miss. He makes it, and they inbound easily. So a couple of mental errors for the Hall down the stretch when they needed the three. They shot the two. They needed a miss. They end up making it. And UConn hangs on just barely to win it by one, 57 to 56. So the Hall now finishes up at 15 and 14. They, too, will hope for a bid in the NIT. The game you are watching on ESPN2, the LaSalle Explorers down big to Rhode Island, 44-29. Stick around. More scores and highlights coming up.
He came from the streets of Brooklyn with only a dream in his heart. He practiced night and day, day and night, all in the hope of becoming a big-time player. But in the end, it was something his mother said that he'll never forget.
Child, you've completely wasted your time.
And indeed he had. For if he had played 7-Up Score for a Million game, he could have won a chance to shoot for $1 million live on ESPN or win other great prizes. Maybe Mama can buy you a jump shot.
We don't make the boat, we make it faster. We don't make the safety seat, we make it more comfortable. We don't make the studio, we make it quieter. We don't make the golf clubs, we make them more powerful. At BASF, we don't make a lot of the products you buy, we make a lot of the products you buy better. BASF.
Like blue on the corners and it's hugging tight. It's got a rag top and a contour hood. She goes up, 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 and she's rocking. Let's go!
The 1999 Mazda Miata. Set it free and it'll return the favor.
Check out some action from the ACC. Duke up big right now on Virginia. They still got about 5 minutes to go in the first half as the winner will get a bye to the semifinals on Saturday. And elsewhere, it's LSU and Florida in the SEC tournament. Florida here up big 25-10. They beat LSU by 19 in the only meeting of this season. We'll bring you highlights a little later on ESPN News. For those of you on the Deuce, we'll send you back to your Atlantic 10 matchup between LaSalle and Rhode Island, and it's a 44-29 game at the half. For those of you on the Deuce, second half coming up. For those of you on the news, we continue after this.
Lock the car.
Bad boys, what you want,
how about
Pepsi One?
We don't do one calorie.
We don't do one calorie.
You'll do this.
Let me help.
New Pepsi One, one calorie.
This tastes great.
True cola taste.
Pepsi!
Introducing the new Kaiser Miller Ford Superstore in Collegeville, Central Montgomery County's first superstore. Over 500 new and used vehicles to choose from, with everyday discount pricing, the highest trade-in amounts anywhere, and an award-winning service department. You'll lower your cost of driving at the new Kaiser Miller Ford and pre-owned Superstore. 2 miles from Route 422 on Route 29 in Collegeville.
Come on, he's taking too long.
I should have gone.
Yeah, you should have gone, man. You should have gone.
Stow it. He's coming, and he's gone.
This is all I can get.
You did good, Billy. You did real good.
Yeah, the boy should have planted that 3 hours ago.
For the great taste that won't fill you up and never let you down, make it a Bud Light.
Can I go now?
No.
This halftime report is presented by 7-Up. Are you an un?
Dave Feldman in the Deuce studio as the halftime report continues, presented by 7-Up, and we'll take you out to the WAC and let you know about the New Mexico Lobos. Because of their 22 wins, 19 have come at home. So a lot of people say they can't play on the road or in a neutral site. How about a highlight? New Mexico and Rice. Greg Davis, up strong and one. Let's update you on the WAC quarterfinal right now. High five all around for the Lobos as they lead by three, 45-42. The Owls have lost three straight meetings. Elsewhere, the snack in the WAC comes your way, and it's on ESPN tonight at midnight. SMU and UNLV. We may be done with the Deuce after this game, but we're not done with our coverage. Switch it over to ESPN at midnight for the Mustangs and the Running Rebels. Currently on ESPN right now, though, it's the Big East. Rutgers, a bubble team perhaps, 49-53. They trail St. John's. Rutgers is 5-5 versus St. John's lifetime at Madison Square Garden. Our halftime score right now, it's 44-29 Rams over the Explorers. We'll return to Dave and Jay right after this break.
This is a world only a few know well. A world of risk and uncertainty. Where the roads can take you to success or prosperity. Or sometimes to no place at all. This is the financial world. For decades, banks and investment firms of mountainous size have ruled the land. Yet, high above the horizon, another mountain has risen. A mountain called First Union. With 16 million customers, the nation's eighth largest brokerage, and sixth largest bank. For a new perspective of the financial world, come to the mountain called First Union. Or if you prefer, the mountain will come to you.
You can't see anything in a car. You can't see past the guardrails in a car. That's why we don't make tiny little cars.
Look, Mommy, a tugboat!
Really? In the water?
Yeah.
In fact, we don't make cars, period.
Mommy, birds!
Wow!
We prefer the view from the look outside and see the world as Suzu Trooper.
Look, Mommy, space though!
Because you never know what you might miss.
ESPN2's exclusive presentation of Championship Week is brought to you by First Union, your guide to the financial world, and by Isuzu. We don't make cars because life's too big for cars.
Liberty Place, big skyline here in Philadelphia. Halftime, A-10 quarterfinals, Rhode Island with a big lead at halftime. Here in Philly, Dave Sims and Jay Billis with you again. The difference maker, how about Ed Brown? He comes into the game, last 12 minutes, Rhode goes on a 35-11 scoring binge.
And Ed Brown had 8 points. He grabbed 3 rebounds, a steal. He had 2 assists. He was fantastic, but it was really the Lamar Odom show. 17 points, 5 rebounds. There with the mismatch, Julian, don't call me Lance Blanks, trying to guard him. And Ed Brown just throwing Victor Thomas out of the way. And Victor Thomas saying, where's the foul, man?
Numbers for the first 20 minutes. And free throws. Both teams really didn't get there a lot. 3-point shooting. And LaSalle, 4 of 13. Turnovers, 13. And Odom with the big numbers, 7 of 12 from the field for 17 points.
A lot of turnovers for LaSalle. Only one turnover in that entire first half for Rhode Island. That by Tavoris Bell. Maybe Jim Herrick shouldn't start him.
Well, Bell does get the start. Luther Clay with 3 fouls. Just Odom. Reynolds Dean and Preston Murphy for LaSalle. It's Butler, Carr, Thomas, Blanks, and Wesson.
And that is very unusual to go a whole half with only one turnover. And I used to have two turnovers by the time warm-ups were over.
Luther Clay coming off the calf injury with the putback, 46-29.
And Clay still limping a little bit, yeah, with that calf injury, but he always seemed to limp more running back on defense.
Miss by Thomas. Donnie Carr over Reynolds Dean, banked it home. And that's a three ball.
Shades of Jack Gibbons in the 78, yeah, title game.
Foul before Murphy passed the ball. First foul on Blanks, and this LaSalle team, a bunch of Ironmen, they're not gonna get deep into that bench.
Four players averaging over 14 points a game, all of them capable of 20, even 30 point nights. And only Kazel Wesson and Rasual Butler putting up some numbers near double figures in that first half. Each of them had eight.
Danny Carl struggled. Tavares Bell playing his part.
Well, Bell is a very good defender. A terrific run and jump athlete. Once jumped over a car on the playground on a dare.
Jump hook by Odomoko.
I asked Jerry DiGregorio about that, with Bell jumping over a car, and he said, well, it was just a compact car. And, oh, forget it then.
Yeah.
It's not an SUV. It doesn't really count.
It works in my book. Turnaround by Wesson, and he'll be able to get everything he wants against Clay Luther, playing with three fouls. And Wesson with 10 points. Tell you what, not much of a factor. Good hustle by Blanks. Backcourt violation because Blanks hit the ball from Brian Fisher. Bell, well, he's struggling tonight. Breakout, Donnie Carr. Lamar Odom will let him go, and Donnie Carr lays it up and in.
When your point guard goes down low on penetration, somebody has to rotate back. That time it was Lamar Odom. Odom didn't realize it, and Donnie Carr got the easy deuce. Maybe that'll get him off the snide.
8 points for Donnie. Clay, wheels, way too many steps. Turnover for Rhode Island.
If you're going to go that far, you got to get there an hour early.
Winner advances to take on George Washington tomorrow night in the semifinals here in the A-10s. Xavier and Temple in the other one.
When you talk about balanced scoring, George Washington put up some numbers tonight. They're three big guns, Mike King, Yegor Masharikov, and Shante Rogers, the A-10 player of the year.
He's a treat to watch, isn't he?
It's amazing how quickly he moves on the court. He's so disruptive.
Thomas intercepts. And it will be a LaSalle ball. It's knocked out of bounds on Tavares Bell.
One of the few times you'll see Lamar Odom force a pass. Jim Herrick upset with his blossoming freshman. He wants him to make the easy pass. Every pass that you make doesn't have to be a scoring pass.
Hard to Thomas. Blanks, point guard, offering up. Thomas, easy rebound. Nice look inside. Kazel Wesson taken away. Quick hands by the defense of Rhode Island.
Looked like Luther Clay got his hand in there. And Victor Thomas with the offensive rebound. He had a terrific rebound in first half at 7 boards in the first half.
Rhode Island won the rebound total, 21-17. Now the turnover for the Explorers. Thomas turns it over. 15 turnovers. Does he walk? There's the left foot established.
Putting it on the floor, and he picked up that left pivot foot as he was putting the ball down. That in and of itself is not illegal. LaSalle still staying man-to-man, but they're really sloughing off, not going out past the three-point line to guard, except on Lamar Odom, and Butler is guarding him.
Luther Clay, pretty nimble. Loose ball goes to Murphy. Runner in the lane, Preston Murphy. A short foul, and it's on Lamar Odom. Second foul on Lamar. Thomas trying to shake it off until you get there. Big ding there, but he's going to try to walk it off. Left thigh.
James Jordan will come into the ball game and replace him.
Mark DiStaola stops play for the injured player, and they get him on the bench. James Jordan does indeed enter the game. A lot of discomfort for Thomas. Here's what happened.
Take a look right in the middle of your screen. Looked like he just got a hyperextended left knee there as Odom bumped into him.
There's a good matchup here, Bell against Carr. Carr with a step, finds Blanks. Back out to Butler. Wow, Luther Clay really got away with that one. Keep it alive. New clock for LaSalle.
Well, Rhode Island has really done a good job on their help and recovery defense. That's a foul.
Butler, baseline jumper. Lamar Odom takes over for Rhode Island.
Couple of opportunities for LaSalle. They came away with nothing. They got very few offensive rebound opportunities in that first half.
Reynolds Dean draws the foul. Close to a travel. A lot of LaSalle fans up in arms over that one. Fouls on Jordan, his first. Second team foul on LaSalle.
Antonio Reynolds Dean. Very good handler, especially for a guy 6'7", and it did look like he shuffled the feet just a little bit, but he also drew the contact, and the contact was what was called by the officials.
10 points, 4 rebounds for Antonio Reynolds Dean today.
And Reynolds Dean comes out of Atlanta, where he had a pretty good class. Out of that state, Sharif Abdul-Rahim, Vontigo Cummings, Ricky Moore, Jabari Smith down at LSU, Ray Harrison from Georgia, Tom Weidman at Clemson, and Shernard Long, late of Georgetown. So a good group coming out of Georgia that year.
Reynolds Dean with a couple of free throws gives Rhode Island a 48-36 lead here in the A-10 quarterfinals, 4 minutes in, second half.
We don't build commuter cars or get you to work fast pinstriped cars. We don't build cars, period. We built the 205 horsepower, get out of town fast Isuzu Rodeo. Because there's more to life than the daily commute.
All dry.
How do you plan on paying unexpected medical bills? Conseco's supplemental health policies can help. Conseco, step up.
Today, people who didn't send the money, Western Union, and the heartbreak it caused. So what happened?
My Aunt Leona called. She was throwing a party and she sprung a leak.
She did?
Well, her tub did. And I told Mercury here to send money.
I did.
But not Western Union.
Her aunt sprung a leak and you didn't use Western Union?
No, and it took forever.
And what does Aunt Leona have to say?
Hey, it's your money. Use Western Union, the fastest way to send money worldwide.
Dave Feldman in the studio moments ago from the WAC, the quarterfinals. New Mexico, time running out. Lamont Long off glass, a beauty. And that was a very nice shot to put them up. 51-49, 2 seconds left in this game. And in the Pac-10 from the pit, Stanford and Oregon, it's 12-6. The sixth-ranked Cardinal are up on top. Let's go back to Dave and Jay Bill.
Back here in Philadelphia at the A-10 quarterfinals, Dave Sims and Jay Billis with you. 12-point lead for Rhode Island.
Rhode Island has just dominated down on the low block, whether it's off offensive rebounds, getting the ball down to Lamar Odom when he's got a mismatch, or Antonio Reynolds Dean inside. They've done a great job of feeding that ball into the post, and on the other end, it's all Kazel Wesson for LaSalle.
Donnie Carr pulls from up top. Rebound to Murphy. Rams on the run again.
And that was too tough of a shot.
Sure was. Turnover. Tavares Bell traveled.
Victor Thomas back into the
Jim Herrick begs to disagree. Nice to see Victor Thomas back into the game.
A 1-4 set for LaSalle.
play, very aggressively playing Wesson. Thomas right down the lane, and he got fouled. It's on Clay, it's number four, and it is. It's a fourth foul on Luther Clay.
Luther Clay waited for that block. He didn't step up to try to take a charge. He was thinking block all the way. Close out by Antonio Reynolds Dean, not under control, and just a little tick of the hand up at the top by Luther Clay, enough to draw a foul. Nice job by Victor Thomas to get all the way to the basket.
Quick recovery by Thomas. We saw him. Lots of discomfort just a few minutes ago. So Big Ed Brown on the left coming back into the game. Tip Vincent, they come in for Clay and Murphy. The bench points, bench just watching right now.
Well, that's the way it's been for most of the year. Speedy Morris has gone with his starters for the great majority of the minutes that he has to offer, and they've come through for him, especially offensively. But it is not as good of a defensive team, and primarily because they don't get a rest. They have to pace themselves.
Wesson banging it underneath.
Yeah, Kazel Wesson very aggressive going after the ball. He has only one speed, and that is full speed all the time. He understands where he can be successful on the floor, and he gets there. Nice pass.
And he missed the dunk. Tavares Bell was right there. Great setup from Odom.
Not sure what he was trying to do there. It looked like he tried to pull it back a little bit and then put it back up again. And Tavares Bell, a great leaper. He's had several highlight reel dunks this season.
Good pick set by Wesson. Pull up by Carr. Donnie struggling mightily from the field. Reynolds Dean rebounds.
Well, he's gotten no open looks. Just about every shot has been contested.
Sure. Reynolds Dean, nice dip. And Brown, he missed it, but he'll go to the line.
And Antonio Reynolds Dean, very effective when he runs down the middle of that court. He can hit that shot along the top of the key, the free throw line. Brown trying to go all the way deep, and Kazel Wesson has to come over and try to stop that penetration. And when he comes back over after the dish down, gets a little bit of the body on Ed Brown. And Kazel Wesson obviously didn't agree.
Sure enough, second foul on Kazel. .403 to go. Ed Brown has played well in his time here this evening. You mentioned coming off a 22-point performance in the loss Sunday to Fordham. Up top, here's Wesson. Butler, now to Blanks.
Rhode Island's done a great job of negotiating screens. Everything has been contested.
Butler, that won't go. They keep it alive. Wesson can't save it. The Rhode Island basketball.
Rasual Butler has had to settle for jump shots a lot, not putting the ball on the floor as much.
But Vincent taking it all away. Count that. Tip Vincent. Vincent, a freshman out of New Britain, Connecticut. St. Thomas Aquinas High School.
This was a young man that was planning on redshirting this season, but was forced into duty when Preston Murphy got injured and Zach Marbury was declared ineligible. And he has played very well. He was a top 50 player in high school for Jerry DiGregorio, now an assistant to Jim Herrick at Rhode Island. He's had mostly spot duty this season. His job is to come in and value the basketball, not turn it over, and to play good defense. And he has done that. He's getting better and better.
For LaSalle, that foul was the third on Wesson. Butler on the attack. Contact. Offensive foul. His second foul.
And what a great job by Antonio Reynolds Dean. That's why in 1997 he was on the A-10 all-defensive team. Look at him come over from the weak side and how far he has to travel in order to get that charge. That is a great job. And Rasual Butler finally putting the ball on the floor and taking it inside, but just a little bit out of control. But give credit to Antonio Reynolds Dean.
Odom posting on Butler. Had to take it away. Blanks. Good pass. Missed shot by Thomas.
He didn't really square himself, did he? Just kind of exposed it.
Ed Brown! Oh, my goodness! On the alley-oop from Vincent.
College basketball's refrigerator pairing.
Earth control to Major Brown. Very impressive. And let's go to the studio and Dave Feldman.
All right, Dave, thanks very much. The WAC quarterfinal moments ago. Rice with a last chance, down two, 2.8 left. Alex Bugayev is up, and it's short. New Mexico holds on to beat Rice by two. Dave and Jay, back to you guys.
All right, thank you, Dave. And I tell you what, our star of the game so far, they're certainly the difference maker, Mr. Brown.
We have liftoff. That was a nice look by Vinson to get the ball down court, and Ed Brown getting down there as well. And he has had a terrific ball game. His confidence is just growing and growing as games go by.
Well, it should. Wesson can't get the roll. Keep it right here. Foul against Rhode Island. By the way, Mr. Brown is shooting 5 for 5. 11 points tonight off the bench. Reynolds Dean, the foul is first.
But the thing that amazes me so much about Ed Brown is how quick he is.
Oh.
At his size, able to move, and Jim Herrick.
Oh, man, there's some range there. Butler, tell you what, he Butler and Odom can trade on range ball there, because a couple of weeks ago, folks, Jay and I were in Rhode Island for the UMass game, and you see where that Bell Atlantic patches across the court from about right there, about that distance, Lamar Odom hit as comfortable a jump shot as you could ever see.
Yeah, pulled up from 35, a 5 second call there on Antonio Reynolds.
Almost in Speedy Morris's lap.
Rasual Butler, and he took it right with some late pressure from Lamar Odom. Then he had something to say to Lamar running down the court, and Odom just started laughing.
Knocked away. Bell will finish. And he gets him up there. Tavares Bell with the steal and the slam. He's got 4. 55 to 40. Biggest lead of the evening. 4 Rhodey.
Rhode Island has been in control of this basketball game since the 10-minute mark of the first half.
And Brown changed that shot. Reynolds Dean takes over. Breakout. Pass to Bell. Fumbles. Can't get it. Odom's there. Who wants it? Odom will settle and get it out. Finds Bell, and he stepped on the baseline. It'll be LaSalle ball. Rhode Island fans in an uproar. But they have got to be pleased, up by 15. And the People's Choice, Ed Brown playing a big role tonight. Tip Fitz in the great look, and look at the completion here and the flush by Ed Brown.
Where do they find this one?
Chapel Hill.
Toxicology?
Negative.
You can't see anything in a car. You can't see past the guardrails in a car. That's why we don't make tiny little cars.
Look, Mommy, a tugboat!
Really? In the water?
Yeah.
In fact, we don't make cars, period.
Mommy, birds!
Wow!
We prefer the view from the look outside and see the world as Suzu Trooper.
Look, Bob, a space shuttle!
Because you never know what you might miss.
Wow!
In a car.
There are many ways you can get stuck with a flat tire. But not with this tire. Even with no air pressure, you keep driving to safety. The Goodyear AquaSteel Run Flat. It could be the difference between getting stuck and getting there. Only from Goodyear.
Goodyear.
To 40, Rhode Island over LaSalle here, 11:16 to go. And we are certainly running a little bit late, but the reason, George Washington took a long time to eliminate Dayton in the third quarterfinal of the day. George Washington advancing to the semifinals. They'll meet the winner of tonight's game.
but coming up tomorrow here in Philadelphia.
And GW put up 100 points off of Dayton. They beat them 100-90. That is a team that can score and score in a hurry.
Kazell Wesson, foul line jumper. He's got 12 points. His second field goal here in the second half. Atlantic 10 quarterfinal action from the First Union Spectrum in Philadelphia. I'm Dave Sims with Jay Billis. Cross court pass from Ed Brown and Tip Vincent. The South started off very well, pretty much picking up where they left off last night. Then Rhode Island finished the half with a 35-11 run over the last 12 minutes to take the lead. They just built on it. Reynolds Dean with the score. He's got 14.
Reynolds Dean showing that he's multi-dimensional. He can hit that shot from the free throw area out to about 17 feet. You have to guard him, and he's also got the ability to put it on the floor and get past you.
Second foul on Torrey Jefferson. He just came into the game.
Because he can dribble the ball and handle it so well, when Victor Thomas got too far onto his left shoulder, that opened up the right. And Antonio Reynolds Dean able to take it all the way in and finish.
Weston's had a lot of trouble against Ed Brown. He scores on him this time.
That's the second time he's got the ball in the second half. Along the left block, he just gives a little head and shoulder fake and goes middle.
Keeps it simple, doesn't he?
And knows where he's successful. He just keeps going at it and forces you to stop it.
Jefferson being guarded by Butler. And they get a hand check. Fouls on Donnie Carr, his second foul.
Kazell Wesson gets great position down low, and he's got Ed Brown just kind of standing up. And here's that little head and shoulder fake. And the nice turnaround over that left shoulder, little baby hook. Kazell Wesson's got a nice package of post moves down low, and really requires somebody to come over and double him to get him to give it up.
We've got about 7 of 10 for Kazell Wesson. Knocked away, good hustle, Thomas. Thomas will win this battle. Victor Thomas got a spark. LaSalle, it's 57-46 now, Rhode Island. Murphy tries to restore some order, they'll back it out.
There's still plenty of time in this ballgame. It's an 11-point game.
Sure enough. Murphy, pull up, got it. It's a two for Preston Murphy. So Rhode Island buying some time now as they give Lamar Odom a blow.
Well, Preston Murphy had one of the great shooting performances of the season earlier this year. Went 8-for-9 from three against Temple.
Fallon Brown, his second.
Take a look here. The steal by Victor Thomas going the other way. Good hands knocking it away, and the nice finish.
About the numbers for Wesson this evening. He's had a little cold spell. Latter stages of the first half with Brown on him, but he's got 15 points now. 7 of 10 from the line, from the field rather, and 8 rebounds.
Well, he leads the Atlantic 10 in both rebounding and field goal percentage. 7th in the nation in rebounding.
Averages a double-double. Carr had a tough shooting night. It continues. Ed Brown rebound. Outlet again. Second time he's done that. How about the hesitation by Murphy to get that shot off? Boy, Ed Brown definitely has a feel for the game. He knew Murph was down there.
And he just whips that ball back behind his head and jettisons it down court. Blanks had the opportunity to make the steal. He just missed it. And Murphy just couldn't get that ball to go.
Well, it's like a guided missile. What a weapon to have. Jim Harrick calls him the best outlet passer he's ever had on the team. And Odom coming back into the game.
Well, it is a good outlet pass, but I know that Speedy Morris down on the other bench wants that kind of ball picked off.
Sure.
I mean, that thing was in the air a long time, and he'd like to see Julian Blanks pick that thing off and go the other way.
So Murphy's 64% at the line, makes it 61-47, Rhodey.
Rhode Island is stuck with man-to-man just about the whole game. Nice job by Odom to go over that screen to catch up with Sue Butler.
Donnie Carr
Gets it to Kazell Wesson. Thomas down low and knocked out of bounds. And a foul against Torrey Jefferson. What about Donnie Carr? You're talking about struggling. 3 of 12 on the night.
Quite a contrast from last night against St. Joseph's, where he had 21 points, 5 assists, and a terrific all-around performance. And he's a young man that's become a complete player. Led the nation's freshman in scoring 2 years ago and led the Atlantic 10 in scoring. And when you say led the nation's freshman in scoring, that included guys like Larry Hugh, all of them. I mean, he led all of them in scoring.
Discussion there, that was the 16th foul, although I believe that was 16th foul, not a shooting foul. All right.
Good pass.
They get it inbounds. Ed Brown forces Wesson to miss the easy one.
Dodged a bullet. Brown fell asleep on the inbound.
Sure did.
They just lobbed it over his head, and Wesson didn't finish. One of the things coaches spend a lot of time on in scouting reports is out-of-bounds plays. That's kind of like those games can be decided by out-of-bounds.
Sure enough.
How you execute off those plays, getting quick baskets, fouls, and how you defend it.
Murphy wide open, and he hit it. So Preston Murphy is able to shake free. Murphy's in his last couple from the field. He's got 8.
Well, he's very good at moving without the ball. He spent a lot of time as an off-guard playing with Tyson Wheeler. And that 8-for-9 performance from 3 had against Temple was remarkable. Only Marcus Wilson of Evansville had a better performance. He went 9 of 9 in a game earlier this year.
Well, Sal turns it over. When we come back, it will be Rhode Island ball. Preston Murphy, a lot of room, and he made LaSalle pay right there.
I tell you, I grilled a sea bass last night. A little olive oil, cilantro, fabulous. Harry's a chef over here.
Yeah, what was that thing you made the other night?
You mean a paella?
Paella. You know you can steam a fish in a dishwasher?
What?
Just wrap it in aluminum foil and shove it in there.
Unbelievable. I'm not talking to you.
Well, what are you taking, cooking lessons now, Harry?
Guys, you know me, I'm the Renaissance man.
Renaissance. Hi, Harry.
Hi, how you doing? Who was that?
We connect you to your favorite shows, sports, and movies, and now we connect you to your favorite people. Suburban Cable wants to send every customer a personal pager at no charge.
This is a good thing.
With monthly service as low as $7.95 added to your cable bill. Call 800-885-BEEP and get your pager at no charge from Suburban Cable. We'll keep you connected to network like CNN, and we'll bring you all the news. 800-885-BEEP. It's great to be connected.
Big East quarterfinals now history. St. John's wins 77-62. They will play Miami tomorrow, a team that beat them twice during the regular season. And in the Pac-10, Cal, they're a bubble team. They need to beat Oregon State and Oregon if they're going to have a chance at the dance. They lead by 2. Let's go back to Dave and Jack.
Thank you, Dave Feldman. Back here at the A-10 quarterfinals, Roding. Impressive lead, 63-47. And a reminder that Championship Week continues, and we'll update you on some of the games coming your way. A Rhode Island fan. A lot of fans made their way down here to Philadelphia. Full court pressure now extended by LaSalle.
With 2-2-1.
Vincent pulls a tip up. Ed Brown kept it alive. Jefferson couldn't get it. Brown kept it alive again. Here comes Blanks. The lefty won't go for him, and Odom rebounds for Rhode Island.
Lamar Odom, just about every time he goes out, gets a double-double these days.
Nice block by Wesson. Murphy running the baseline. Tip Vincent up top. Here's Brown.
Now LaSalle trying to extend their defense a little bit. The only guy they're not guarding on the perimeter is Brown.
And count it for Lamar Odom.
Oh, he just abused Butler on that one.
Kazel Wesson doing a nice job defensively to get this block, coming over from the weak side and knocking Preston Murphy's shot away with that left hand. And here is Lamar Odom working off that low block. That's the one thing that I thought his game on the college level has been missing, is consistent post-up ability, where he takes a man down low and works him over with his size and superior handling ability. And he must have heard me, because he is doing it tonight.
19 points, 8 rebounds for Lamar Odom.
There's no question he has got all the skills to be a great player on any level, but you'd like to see him, if he can afford to do it, stay on the college level and continue to work
Wesson
on his game.
Blocked by Odom. Ed Brown takes over. Another good outlet pass. They got numbers 3-on-2. Jefferson takes it all the way. Offensive foul. For Jefferson, his fourth.
Torrey Jefferson taking that outlet pass from Ed Brown, going along the right side. And Rasual Butler a little bit slow getting back and just barely gets there to get that call. And Torrey Jefferson not at all happy about it, but that's one of those that can go either way, and it went against him.
18-point lead for Rhode Island. First 8 minutes of the game, it was all a Salle. It's been Rhode since then. Nice tip by Wesson. He's pretty much the only sign of life for the Explorers. 17 for Kazel. Vincent gets it to Odom. Ryan Jefferson, he'll tee it up. That won't go. Rebound Wesson. Wesson, a terrific game. 12 points, 12 rebounds. Butler outside, guarded by Odom. Pull up. Short. Rebound, Ed Brown. Outlet. This will be a dunk. Odom. Oh, he missed it. How about that? Are you kidding me? Count it, though, for Torrey Jefferson. I thought for sure Odom was going to complete that play. Good job by Blanks to get back on the hustle. Certainly upset the timing by Lamar Odom. Never seen him make a play like that.
Well, it didn't look like he was concentrating on the finish. And when he goes in there to dunk, obviously concentrating on making the play, but a little nonchalant.
Makes up for it right there with the putback.
Well, he knows he had a little lapse there. You can see him shaking his fist as he ran down court. He did get the basket. He just has a load of talent.
21 for Lamar. Donnie Carr just struggling mightily tonight. Wesson faced up on Ed Brown. Won't go for it. Head of the pack, Jefferson again. Jefferson. Guess he hasn't learned his lesson.
Yeah, there was no doubt about that one. That was a charge. And Julian Blanks doing a nice job patiently waiting in position. Again, the outlet pass, this time on the other side of the court, just to make sure he gets full coverage. And Torrey Jefferson just a little bit out of control. He started a game earlier this year against TCU. Then the last game we had with Rhode Island, when they played UMass, Jim Herrick went to put him in the game early, and he realized that he had forgotten to put his jersey on underneath his warm-up.
Can I tell you something? I had a lot of kids come up. They heard you call him that Jersey Jefferson. A lot of kids heard that. They've been on him about it. I liked it, though. I liked that little moniker you stuck on him. Jersey
didn't mean to pick on him. It's just kind of the old maxim. Are you ready to play? And if you don't have your jersey on, you can kind of say, the kid didn't come ready to play.
Tough couple of moments. Jim Herrick lifts Jefferson. That's Tavares Bell back in the game.
You know, Torrey Jefferson, a very good defender. I remember the job he did earlier against Ohio on Ladrell Whitehead. He had a terrific defensive performance.
Oh, my goodness. Look at that pass for Ed Brown. Ed Brown. And they wiped out the bench.
That was a charge there. Hope nobody's hurt over there.
Yeah, really. Blank's a tough kid. Plays hard.
Looked like Tom Garrick. Looked like Tom Garrick drew the charge. Let's see right here.
Garrick.
Is Garrick in position? No, he was moving.
Tommy.
That's a block. Look at Jim Herrick. Jim Herrick's eyes never went off the play. Like, he doesn't. He's like, whatever. Look, he's still looking at the play.
That's remarkable. Wesson with 4:25 to go. Carr still can't get a bucket. Odom. Leave it off.
jammed by Tavares Bell. Oh, it's showtime for Rhode.
Now, that was no compact car he jumped over there. That was an SUV.
Yowza. 4 minutes to go, 73-49. Rhode running away. Murphy. Inside, Bell, another one.
What would that was a three-point takedown by Kaysel Wesson there. He just grabbed Preston Murphy and pulled him down to the ground, and there was no call.
10-0 run, Bell with a foul. Trips Tavares Bell. 3:42 to go. Boy, Murphy, pretty tough kid to get up, and nice sportsmanship exhibited by Mr. Kaysel Wesson. But the regulars for LaSalle pretty much run out of the building this evening. Speedy Morris running up the white flag at the 3:42 mark, down 75-49.
Well, Speedy Morris has done a nice job with this team. Before this game ends, they are 13-14 on the year, 8-8 in Atlantic 10 play, and that is a big jump from where they have been over the last few years. And Ed Brown getting a nice hand as he goes over to the bench.
As well he should. Major impact. Big Ed Brown. Cheering Eddie. Bragg puts it back up and in. For Ed Brown, 11 points, 7 rebounds, and 3 assists. Tough night for Donnie Carr of LaSalle. 3 of 15. And Bell, man, is he a flyer. What, just climbed right up Garrett Bragg. And Kaysel Wesson, tell you what, they put everything into it. Thomas, Wesson, 17 points, 13 rebounds on 8 of 15 shooting. Ed Brown came in and just turned this game around. 8 minutes into the first half.
Yeah, you see those shots of Kaysel Wesson and Victor Thomas over on the LaSalle bench. And you want to say that these games they're not important. They don't mean anything to these kids. They pour their heart and soul into each one of these games.
Lamar Odom. Nice round of applause from the Rhode faithful.
Now this LaSalle team.
24 points, 10 rebounds, Jay.
You know, this LaSalle team is going to improve. And they're going to have everybody back with the exception of Kaysel Wesson. And there is a waiver that they are seeking with the NCAA for an extra year for Wesson. So there is a possibility that they could have all 5 starters back.
Pay tribute to these young men, who a lot of them coming off the bench here getting some playing time. Anwar Wilson, there's James Jordan. Nice looking jump hook by James Jordan.
Nice move, little fake to the middle, turn back toward the baseline.
David Smith's in the game, number 24 for Rhode Island. Andrew Wafula is in the game as well, number 4 for Rhode. And on the ball is Mike Sidebottom, former manager for LaSalle. Tip Vincent.
Tell you what, Charlie Huff would be proud of that shot, but it goes in.
A little knuckle to it.
I mean, there is no rotation. It is a strict knuckleball.
Nice job by Mike Sidebottom. Practice in the first semester out of Wildwood Catholic in New Jersey. Tavares Bell, and let him play some clock here.
And with this win, all 4 teams that received byes in the first round will advance to the semifinals. And shows the importance of finishing in the top 2 in each division.
Bragg going to lead the break, but nobody joining him.
Well, Bragg had a tough start to the season with that stress fracture in his foot.
Tavares Bell, goodness gracious. Serious ups. I don't want to use any company names, but you're exactly right. He might be up to a van on this one, right?
Well, Tavares Bell can flat out fly. I mean, just a terrific athlete. And he has done that a number of times this season. But he's not just a leaper. He has turned himself into more of a complete player.
1:57 to go. Put it in the books for Lamar Odom and Rhode Island. They have dominated LaSalle here in the A-10 quarterfinals.
Oh, here I come. This is how Dale Earnhardt Jr. fans will remember the 1998 NASCAR Busch Series champion. This is how his opponents will remember him.
Seeing nothing but the taillights.
Get the parts that power Dale Earnhardt Jr. AC Delco. If you're not asking for it, you're asking for it.
Just people, normal in every way but one. They expect more from a truck than 99% of the world. We call them the one percenters. With their demanding standards in mind, we introduced the completely redesigned GMC Sierra. One percenters, the wait is over. The all-new Sierra from GMC.
ESPN2's exclusive presentation of Championship Week is presented by 7-Up, Are You In On, and in part by GMC Sierra, for those who demand more from a truck.
A-10 quarterfinals, Rhode Island, a buck 57 away from semifinal action tomorrow night against George Washington. LaSalle, a great 8-minute start at the beginning of the game, but all Rhode Island since then. What are your thoughts on the semis tomorrow night, Jake?
Well, it's going to be a terrific matchup. Two teams that can put points on the board, Rhode Island and George Washington. And I'm really looking forward to seeing Xavier play.
Boy, Lenny Brown did it again today, didn't he?
31 points today as you take a look at the Rhode Island bench. And Lamar Odom still cheering for his teammates. And on the other end, some dejection as the season ends. LaSalle will not be going to postseason play, but they have made some great strides forward this year.
No doubt about it. This will end a three-game win streak. They're going to finish at 13-15 with their record this year.
Well, Speedy and his staff, Tyrone Pitts and Bill Lang, Jim Phillips did a nice job with his team. How about Joe Mahalik, an assistant to Speedy Morris last year, went to Niagara this year, had the nation's leading scorer, Alvin Young, put up about 25 points a game, and they came within a game of going to the NCAA tournament as well.
Would you believe I used to catch Joe Mahalik in grade school? I was in eighth grade, he was in sixth grade. He's a pretty good pitcher.
That's a pretty good heat, could throw it at least 40 miles an hour then.
Great curveball. Started throwing that 12-6 curveball too young. Taught by his father, played in the Yankee farm system back in the late 40s, early 50s. Joey's a great athlete. Final minute of play, good look inside. Wilson can't get it to go. Sidebottom with a good look.
And there is Tom Garrick, an assistant coach to Jim Herrick. Was a player at Rhode Island on that 1988 team with Carlton Owens and Kenny Green that advanced all the way to the Sweet 16. They beat Missouri and Syracuse before falling by just 1 point to Duke. And what a great player he was in college. Of course, we saw the first charge he ever took just a few minutes ago.
I'll have to discuss that with Mr. Garrick after the game. Anwar Wilson, a freshman out of the Bronx, New York, with the JFK High School. Set out last season. Honor roll student all 4 years in high school.
Actually, that entire Rhode Island bench, some pretty accomplished players over there. Jim Herrick Jr. played for his dad at Pepperdine. I actually played against him in the 1985 NCAA tournament in Houston, and Jerry DiGregorio played on the same high school team as Rock Foster. They once combined for 68 points between the two of them. Of course, Foster had 61 back in Connecticut. That broke Mike Jaminski's single game high school
record. D-man. Wilson, deep placed, all go. Almost a pretty good tip by Bragg. Vincent runs it down. Nice job to set up Smith. Put it in. Yes, he does. So Smitty's on the board tonight. Junior out of Columbia, Missouri. Coming up immediately following our game, Sports Century. Take a look at the top 50 countdown. Athlete number 45 and caught some of this the other day. A look at Bill Tilden, big Bill Tilden of the golden age of sports back in the 20s. He dominated the world of tennis. The Herrick family, let's celebrate tonight. They, it's like they're having one of those
a little philosophical discussion yeah, right. of basketball. It looks like the son is losing.
A generational gap in one for senior.
Well, it's nice at the end of the game when you can sit back and laugh. You know you've done a good job and you're moving on to the next round. And Jim Herrick has done a remarkable job with this program. And Al Skinner left the cupboard well stocked, and last year went all the way to the Elite Eight. One of the Cinderella stories of the season.
Final seconds here in A-10 quarterfinals. Jordan puts it up. Nice putback. And that will do it. Anwar Wilson with the bucket. Rhode advances. Final score, 83-58 for Jay Billis. I'm Dave Sims. Thanks for joining us. A dominating performance by Rhode Island. Up next, Sports Century Top 50 Countdown coming your way. This has been a presentation of ESPN, the worldwide leader in sports. For more, log on to ESPN.com, part of the Go Network. Go.com, the final score. Rhode wins it big, 83-58 over LaSalle. Have a good night, everybody.
He came from the streets of Brooklyn with only a dream in his heart. He practiced night and day, day and night, all in the hope of becoming a big-time player. But in the end, it was something his mother said.